They're the poppy one. Yeah. It's a Harley. It's an R1, the guy that rides that. Bloody, he was in t-shirt last time. You can see my old bike. You see that? There's my old bike. It has.
You can put your things inside and snacks.
Yeah. So what's he changed on the bike? He's changed the headlight and he's butchered it. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so he doesn't know what he's doing there.
But if it's a girl.
It's not a girl. It's a Portuguese lad and he's butchered the bloody headlight unit that I put on. That's why the cables are hanging all low.
Used to be your actual bike that you sold to that man.
No, I didn't sell it to him. I sold it to the dealership.
But he must have got it from the dealership.
He did get it from the dealership. Except for... Hold on.
Good morning, everybody, and welcome to Being British Biker. Today you've joined me. I'm out for a ride on the second Mansell's Rideout, breakfast Rideout that is. As you can see, it's not great weather, bit cloudy, bit drizzly, but we're here, and we're here with a nice group of lads. I'm just catching up to them now. Got my daughter on the back of my bike with me. This is her first ride out as well. She's got her comms unit inside her helmet, and she's currently listening to a bit of Disney music, so she's all safe and sound. Just going to overtake this car quickly. This is what we call the 5 mile road in Jersey. So where we've just left is where they do the sprints, and they basically sprint it up to Le Bray Cafe. We're just heading past the water splash. There it comes now. Nope, group of cyclists. Let's overtake those as well. As you can see, I've got my windscreen up. It's quite windy today. So I've just got the adjustable bracket from the 850GSA and just whacked a little spoiler on top. That seems to brush off most of the wind off me, which is good. There we go, just coming up to the back of them now. There's Callum on his little 125.
and there's a GSD on his street, oh no, correction, on his BMW 1250 triple black. I might say street triple there. Out on a ride with my daughter. We're hanging at the back. We're in no rush. I'll keep an eye on my daughter behind me. We've got Callum in front of us. We've got 125.
So following on here, we're just heading to the end of the 5 mile road, coming up to the tack. This is one of the recognised hill climbs over here. This is where they normally start from the bottom here. Now these little bikes are going to struggle getting up this hill because it's quite a steep incline, so they're okay at the moment. There we go, right bend. It's steeper than it looks. Alright, Callum's little bike's struggling there. So let's just shoot past him. Yeah, he's okay. I'm gonna take a left up here, I reckon. There we go.
Bloody hell.
Usually hang right at the back, but those two are falling quite short. They're only on 125s. See, the guys at the front are probably doing the speed limit, whereas the tail unit will be doing a little bit more just to keep up. Really, the 125 should be near the front, to be honest. And we've got a GSD here in front of us. He's riding his brand new 1250 GS triple black 2022 model. It's a beautiful bike. You can follow him on YouTube as well. Just waving me through. Now we're back behind this idiot again. Oh. don't know why he's putting his foot down. He's riding like an absolute loon at the moment. And they wonder why we get a bad rep as motorcyclists. Yeah, keep looking behind you, pal. I'm right behind you. Poor guy in front of him on the cruiser probably crapped himself knowing that that guy's behind him. Rev the lek at the moment. Wearing normal trousers and a pair of trainers. Idiot, absolute idiot. Cyclist in front of you with a guy on a cruiser and you're trying to pop a wheelie. You lose control and you're going to cause an accident. What an idiot. And again. Right up the back of the cruiser. No sympathy if that lad comes off the bike, absolutely no sympathy, and I wouldn't stop for him either. On the north coast now, just gonna head on down this way. So Mr. Happy Throttle is no longer in front of us, he's now behind us. Good note, at least all the roads are clean. As you can see, Broncage has been through, farmers have cut back the majority of their hedges, and they've not left all the crap on the road this time, so that's a good thing. These roads can normally be a nightmare when you're riding down here. Go, so north coast, heading towards Bully Bay. Still a little bit drizzly here. It's that horrible misty rain. Gets everywhere. Sorry guys, and it's not Bully Bay we're heading to, it's Bon Oui. It's Good Night Bay. So we're headed to Bon Oui Bay. car. This old bloke, he needs to learn to lean this bike. He's looking around for them. No, they're not in there, mate. Bye. Dry. Only wet spots in a few places. B's and E's to the left of us. It's a nice little cafe there. Get some nice bacon buddies from B's and E's. Some nice sweeping roads up here. And we're back with the Rat Pack. Say this bike is brilliant. I mean, the protection you get on it when riding, it's easy to lean, throw it left and right, no issues. My daughter's on the back, got the top case with the cushion, she's happily sitting there listening to her music. Say BMW needs to do something about their look at that. So he's got his indicator on there, but the red is so prominent that you can barely see his indicator flashing on the left. He brought this up in his own video not long ago with regards to the LEDs on the BMW GS bikes. BMW, do something about it. What good is an indicator if you cannot see it? Trinity Parish Hall. Nothing to the right, and here we go. And we're back to 40. Roselle Bay and goodbye Roselle Bay. Now on to St. Catherine's. Nice spot there to go fishing for bass. There's France off there in the distance. Yeah, 1250GS. GSD needs to remove that sound resonator or put an aftermarket exhaust on that bike, because that is very quiet. Removing the sound resonator and just putting a midlink pipe in the bike makes a huge difference in noise. Not so much as in its abusive, but it does make a nice difference, as you can hear from my bike. I've just got the standard exhaust on. All I've taken is a sound resonator out and just put a mid pipe in it, and that cost me what, 60 quid? God, if anyone's epileptic, don't sit behind a GS bike. Just look at them just flash on and off. And here we go. Thank you.
There's a horse. A horse. There's a horse coming down the river.
Family tree.
Oh, by crike. We're now in St. Catharines. See, look at those flashy lights there. So those, that's the new GS, the 2022 model, 1250, triple black. But when, you know, you're just riding around with them flashing like that, it's just off-putting. Already a fair few bikes down here today. Yeah, the Harley boys are out. Guess we're going around again. Oh yes, eh? Here we go. Well, they're following the road. We'll go a bit of off-road. GSD getting his tail out a little bit there. And again. I think I'll be doing that a fair bit when I go to the ABR festival next year. He's just apologising there because I was behind him. He's probably worried that he's just kicked some dirt up onto my bike, but he's okay. So we're coming back on St. Catharines again. And we're going to be going on to the breakwater now. There we go. Now we're gonna stop here for a bite to eat at the Three Archers. This used to be a fishing tackle shop, but now they've changed it to like a small little cafe, which is good. This is what needed down here on the breakwater. Well, thank you for joining me. This is Bean British Biker, and if you like the video, hit the like, subscribe. Okay, cheers guys, it's been an honor and it's been a lovely ride.
Let go. Watch yourself. Come here. Come in there.
Can I take off my jacket so it doesn't get dirty? Ugh. Can I take off my jacket so it's going to get dirty with ice cream?
Yeah.